Alright, before this video starts, I'm just going to say that this turned out a lot longer than I thought it was. I thought it was going to be about 20 minutes max. Yeah, well, I kind of, it was a little bit discombobulated, but I got everything in there. I guess it's okay. I guess I'll, when I watch the whole thing, when I put it all together, see how it is. I might end up reshooting it. And if I reshoot it, you won't see this. But, and I kind of ramble, so that made it kind of long, but I guess there's good information in there. But yeah, I just thought I'd warn y'all that it's a lot longer than I thought it would be, but I think it shows everything pretty good. All right, on to the video. Alrighty, here's the long overdue walk around. Yay! But, yeah, now I got it running, got it driving, might as well do it. It's a 1996 GMC Yukon, I'm stepping in mud, SLE, C1500 two-wheel drive. It's got 6 inches of lift on it. Alright, interruptions. As I was saying, two-wheel drive, C1500, Yukon with 6 inches of lift. It's got the Rough Country 4-inch spindles on it with a 2-inch coil spacer. And then some, they go by multiple names. I forget one of them. There was about 3 different people that sold them, but I got some open control arms from Crown Suspensions. That are designed to work with up to 3 inches of lift, coil lift, so it will help with the alignment. And control arm right there. There is the 4-inch knuckle. A 4-inch spindle, and you're not gonna be able to see the coil spacer because it's up in there. Another mod is I got the Pro Forged tie rod adjusters. Those are nice. And ooh, exposure. And in the rear, I have the 2-inch block that comes with the Rough Country spindles. Plus, I have G3500 Van leafs mixed with the stock leaf springs from my Yukon. Alright, more interruptions, but yeah, as I was saying, you can see how thick the leaf pack is. Plus 2-inch block. The rear is only about 5 inches or so. But to be honest, I can't lift it anymore. It's probably not going to focus all the way up there. But the slip yoke is pretty much all the way out of my transmission. I can't lift it anymore without getting a custom drive shaft. The shocks are Rough Country from the Rough Country kit. Both front and rear. And later on, for steering wise, I added their steering stabilizer that a two-wheel drive does not have. One modification I did have to do on models with airbags, the airbag module is right here, and the plate is supposed to bolt right there with that steering box mount. Well, it's supposed to go up here, and I couldn't do that. So I had to notch it. I welded there and there. I think I welded here. And I can't remember, did I weld on the bottom? No, I didn't. I just welded there to there and there just for support, basically. Still don't know if it helps or not. I haven't been able to really test it because I put it on last year in August or over the summer, maybe June. And I was going to wait till I got an alignment to see if it actually helped with some of the steering, tightening it up just a little bit. Well, I never was able to get that alignment. Went to get an alignment, and they told me that my bushings were bad. So obviously they didn't align me. They didn't charge me for it. I did get my tires. I got one of my tires flipped 180 degrees, and then I got them all rebalanced and got them rotated because I had some vibration. I still got a vibration that I can't get away, and I think it might be an axle issue. This isn't my stock axle. Rear axle. The rear axle is out of a 99 Yukon Denali, full-wheel drive, because I converted it from 5-lug to 6-lug. This is actually my stock 5-lug axle. 342s with a G80. The Denali axle is actually 373s. It's got a G80 though also. So I don't know if it's an issue with this axle or not, because I switched the axles. Did the conversion in the front using the 2500 light duty rotors to get 6-lug in the front, and then I got my tire, and then I put these tires on, so it could either be something with my rear axle or something with one of my rotors. I didn't have that vibration when I was still 5-lug and I had those 35s on there. Yeah, that's some of the stuff I've done. Also, I added these Bushwhacker fender flares. I've always loved fender flares on these trucks. And since it's four-door, these were pretty darn expensive. Luckily, I was able to find them. They were stored in a warehouse since 03. The date code on the box was actually 2003. So these were sitting in the warehouse for over 10 years. And then I showed my light video, I think. I added those little marker lights like the quadra steers. My rims are a 20 by 10 Anthem A37 Commanders with 285 70 20s. Yeah, 285 60 20s. So it's basically a 34. It's a 33.8 Kenta, Kanity, however you say it, Trail Hogs, which are basically a knockoff of the Goodyear Wranglers, but over half the price, about half the price. Tow mirrors, K2XX tow mirrors, painted them black, took them apart, separated all that stuff. I covered that in my mirror video. Heated, they're from a 99 to 01. I swapped the bases and did all that. I got LEDs to replace these with, because these aren't very bright. I got some Cree, I forget the part number, but it's a huge LED. I got two of them. Oh, excuse me, I got four of them. I'm gonna put them in here. I gotta get some drivers, 12 volt drivers, because they won't handle 14 volts. They'll handle like 11.7 to 12.5 maybe. So I got some, I got to get a one or two converters, regulators to regulate it to keep it 12 volts. Those should be, those. Once I put those in there, they're going to be brighter than even factory GM spotlights. Yeah, the paint's kind of rough. The paint is this side. I'm guessing the first owner who had it had a wreck. The last two owners worked with my dad, the one who I got it from and the one who he got it from. They're both my dad's co-workers. Neither of them wrecked it, so I'm guessing the original owner wrecked it at some point in time, because there's actually Bondo in this door. You can tell right there, there's Bondo in this door. You can even tell how that's bent back and bulged. If you pop the backside, you can see the holes that they drilled. So this whole passenger side has been either repainted
or re-cleared. I know it's been repainted somewhat and re-cleared. I don't know if they painted the whole side or if they just painted some of the side. They probably repainted the, they might have repainted the whole thing. There's also this Bondo spot on the hood that peeled off shortly after I got it. It was already cracked. And I'm messing with it. I flaked the rest of it off. So this grill has been most likely been replaced. This fender, I don't know if it was replaced or repaired. This hood was repaired. The doors and stuff were repaired, and this whole side has been repainted. That, besides that spot on my, those two spots on my roof, right there, between those two and between those two over there, this whole side plus the hood is the only thing that's that has been peeling. All of the original paint, besides those the spots between my cab lights on the hood, it's pretty much all the factory paint's intact. It's just the stuff that's been re-cleared that's been peeling. I'm going to repaint it. I don't know when. I don't know what color. I've been bouncing back and forth to where when I first got it, when I didn't know really what if I wanted to keep it or not, when it was stock, I was just going to rattle can it camo, but not a crap rattle can, and actually a decent rattle can, where I was actually going to be wet sanding and buffing and doing all that. Then I don't know what I want to paint it. I don't know if I want to try to keep the factory color, but I don't know. I know in my Jeep I'm going to keep the factory color. I don't know about this. I am going to be painting the fender flares eventually. I got the paint for the fender flares. I got the gold paint for the fender flares that I need to paint the fender flares with. I got some green paint too to try to repair that hood, sand the hood, the roof, where the roof's trying to peel up. I want to repair the roof, because that's definitely a spot I don't want to be rusting through. The doors and stuff, it's not rusting, it's just peel. The clear coat's just peeling. Rear bumper, this is the rear bumper. I built this over the summer. It is a Logan's Metal Products base. I got that for $300. I couldn't argue with the price. But to get the steel was going to be about that much money. So I went ahead and decided to go ahead and buy the bumper complete. I actually built the bumper almost exactly like this, except it doesn't. I had this fold down right here for my buddy's 95. We built the bumper pretty much exactly like this. All out of quarter inch plate. This was cheap, so I went ahead and bought it. The tire carrier, I put on there. The tire carrier, all the stuff for it, I made out of a 2-inch swing arm. This swing arm right here is a 2-inch by quarter inch square tube. This is 2-inch by like 1/8 inch. Is this the 1/8 inch? Yeah, this is the 1/8 inch stuff. This is the more heavy duty stuff. Then this is a slip that I bought. To where I can unbolt it and slide it in and out. The tire plate that I bought, I got a little lock with an Allen. That's a big Allen bolt going through it that I drilled a hole through and locked it. And there's a nut on it also. Gotta see it. Should be that one right. Yeah, I gotta see it. But it's right here. This is not my spare tire. This is my buddy's off his 95. He's got five rims and five tires. His tires he's got on there right now aren't the grabbers. They're something else. But he bought them, and he's letting me borrow it. Haven't decided if I'm going to go ahead and wait to buy another Anthem and Canity, or if I'm going to do something else. Or if I'm going to wait to get it to where when I do the solid axle swap or not. I haven't decided yet. I might go ahead and buy it because he's probably going to, change jobs, and he's driving a lot farther than he was driving. So he's going to be needing tires pretty soon. And, he's probably going to get grabbers. So he's probably going to buy three grabbers. He's probably going to take this rim back. So I'll probably,
either when that happens or before that happens, I'm going to buy me another Anthem. Plus, he wants to make a tire carrier for his truck. So, and he's probably going to get my Anthems anyway. Whenever I do a solid axle swap, I'm going to stay six lug for a while, but then go to eight lug. And when that happens, if he hasn't bought rims yet, I'll let him get these. But yeah, tire carrier. This is the lock, license plate. I got a green LED strip up there for the light. I got the new 7-pin. I actually cut a hole right here, and the plate that these mount on that come with a little elbow bracket, I cut that down and actually welded that on this plate. So, like around here is where I welded and did it smooth. I'll have to tell it to the backside if it's going to light up. I don't know if you can tell, but you might be able to tell that there's a very thin piece of steel in all that. That's where I'm going to want to be. There's where it mounts to the frame, and then there's these big angle pieces that go down to the frame. I had to make that metal piece because this was designed for the truck. Since it was designed for the truck, the factory piece that came with it ended right here where this body mount is. So I had to make my own frame support because it wouldn't, with the SUVs, the body mounts back there, if it was a truck, there would have been no problem. I would have been able to mount it, no problem. No spare tire under there, obviously. I'll eventually get an onboard air kit and probably throw a train horn in with it. There's more of the bumper right there. Got the pull pin for the safety lock. It locks it closed, and then locks it at 90 degrees, and then locks it a little bit farther open. And then I welded that stop on there after the fact because that stop's not there, and it passes this. It goes into the body and tries to break my tail light. And those are just generic eBay LED tail lights. Fuel cap door that I added. 102-inch CB antenna. There's the tire carrier open. Again, that's the mount. I took some rubber pieces that we put on a bed stake. The bed stake, and you tighten down the bed stake, and this balloons up to stay in the bed stake. I cut those in half. I'm using that as a little rubber stop. Got these. I showed those in my... got one there. Also got one here. And that goes for my ID bar, the triple ID bar, and then that's an ID light, that's an ID light, and that's an ID light. Those are all red. And then those four and those four are white. And I have that both tied into my reverse and a switch on the dash. To tidy up my wiring, took some quarter inch, maybe? Square tube, welded it down here. Welded it alternating up and down. And then right here, right there, there, and there. And then that's for my wiring, and of course put a hole in it. Just like on the other side, I got one of these. Those are actually flag mounts. I drilled holes in the bumper on both sides, four holes, and then I built this box and then put that there. And it fits a copper tube, 3/4 inch? No, 3/8. I don't know off the top of my head. It's a copper tube that fits in this 1-inch tube. It might even be a 3/4 inch, but it's flag mount for different stuff. Got an alarm. Oh, wait a minute. That's right. Back here, nothing really exciting. There's my Vortec box that I took off. I deleted the Vortec box. Pom-poms. I didn't put this. There's my jumper cables. My old fuel door. That came with the truck. It's a 15-inch Memphis. I want to get rid of it and get 212s.
I've been saying that for 2 years though, and it hasn't happened yet. I'm lazy. There's no carpet, and there's no carpet throughout everything. There's no carpet because this leaks. This hatch leaks, and it's been leaking since before I got it. And man, it reeked. So I just ripped all the carpet out. I'm going to bedline the floor. I'm going to bedline all the floor. Yeah, man, it really reeked. I got the wiper cover off. There's a plastic cover that's supposed to go over this wiper. It's almost like an electrical connection. Every once in a while, the wiper doesn't work. And I just fiddle with this and it starts working again. So I keep that off. That's actually a bigger wiper. I think that's a 16-inch wiper. And the stock's a 13-inch. Put an oversized wiper on the back. That's a different third LED brake light. The stock LED brake light had some LEDs out on it. And I actually like these because it has... It's not going to focus in it. It has those square LEDs. It's not going to focus. But it has those square... Yeah, there it goes. It has those same those square LEDs. Those are the same square LEDs that are in the tail lights. And those LEDs are nice. It doesn't have the standard 5-inch LEDs. I need to play with that. The gasket... I didn't like the gasket that came with it, so I took the gasket off the factory. And you might be able to tell it's kind of bowed. I just need to get some rubber, just a rubber mat, flat rubber mat, and change that around. The previous owner jackknifed, so got a nice hole right there. It's got some little dings and dents, nothing major. The steps on the side, this actually came factory with steps. When I got it, it did not have steps. Since I lifted it, one of my parents and some other people who might be height challenged, I wanted them to be able to get in and out of it, so I went to pull apart, got some factory steps, and bedlined the steps with some spray bedliner. This side is bent though. This side bends down, the metal does. I got another base, another bracket. I've just been too lazy to put it on. The exhaust, and when I got it, it had a Flowmaster 50 on it going back into the duals. I cut it off right after the 50s, drove like that for a while. I went to the junkyard for $20. I got two Flowmaster 40s right there. So I put the Flowmaster 40s on there, and holy crap, it resonated like crazy. So I took the stock exhaust piping and did two angles right there. Used my stock tips and put it straight out the side. The cats, one of the cats I cut out, the other cat I gutted. I had some problems with the downpipe breaking off at the donut gasket, so I fixed that. There's this LE. Another reason for body work, you can tell the other side, it's not there. I guess the body shop forgot to put the SLE symbol back on. In the front, wow, this is a long video. In the front, I got Lightworks LED bar with halo. You might notice from some of my older videos I don't have the wings on the brush guard, winch brush guard. I can't believe I can't think of the brush guard brand that I think it is. Because if you notice right here on my fenders, both sides, I got a mark right here. And it's from they bounce a lot. And it was rubbed into here. Generic eBay headlight set with my own halos that I installed. I changed these white to green. Lightworks Off-Road, which... You know, it's not even Lightworks Off-Road anymore. It's I looked the other day, and it's Colorworks now. Colorworks Off-Road, I think. But that's their GMC emblem inserts, and that's a 2015 GMC emblem that I took the inserts out and put the LEDs in it. The color change, I also painted it green. The green's all cracking off and whatnot, but it is what it is. Anthem decal over there. Cab lights, I installed the cab lights. Here's a closer look at that cracking. Doing that on both sides, right there and over there. Got green LEDs in the cab lights. Green LEDs here. These are 50 watt Cree LEDs. There's four in the front, and then there's two down each corner. There's actually Cree. And my reverse lights, I have 80 watt up from the same people. Cree LEDs. It's three down each side, and then four in the front. This door handle I replaced. This door handle broke when I got it. Kill switch for my remote start. You're probably not gonna be able to see it. And can't turn on light. But my alarm brain, there's relays for the alarm brain. And the alarm is a little bit farther up. I installed an alarm. It's an Omega Excalibur 2060 is the numbers, I believe. This is the, I replaced the outer pulley. I got the tensioner pulley today to replace. Pioneer DHX870BH. I like that. I love that radio. It's got Bluetooth. There's a Bluetooth remote. There's my alarm antenna. Some switches. I gotta actually map this out. I can put 10 switches up here. I actually bought a pack of 10 just in case. This goes to my cab lights. I have my cab lights on an on-off switch. Don't really know why. That's for my underglow. Got the overhead console. It seems like all these trucks, the visor is crappy. Light still works, but the visor's shot. I've been trying to find visors for a couple years now. It's pretty much since I got the truck. Put green LED in these, obviously. If you saw my other video, green LEDs in there. Got a Cadillac gauge cluster, so it goes to 120. The mileage is right because I took it apart, changed all the LEDs to green, and swapped my mileage over. My battery's fixing to die. Alright, plugged up my camera. And also, you notice that light's supposed to be orange. I went through, took this circuit board out behind here, changed every single one of those LEDs to green. Did all my HVAC stuff too also. Even the LEDs behind there. K-A band. Laser. I did the LEDs in here. This turns on those ID bars in the back, the white lights on the ID bars. Comes in useful if you're towing a trailer and it's at night and you have like a four-wheeler or something on it, you want to keep a watch for it. You know how people tow stuff in their bed or their truck and they leave their cab light on. That's what I use when that. Cops, I actually don't seem to mind. I've driven by plenty of cops at night when I've had that little light on the trailer. They don't care, and to be honest, it's actually not that bright. It's bright that you can see stuff, so it's useful in that way, but if it was a light bar, obviously, they'd probably pull me over. This goes to those lights in the grill. CB, didn't mention that. CB, yeah, floorboard, no carpet. What else do I got here? Toyota Supra headlights. Anybody want some? No, not really. Those are messed up. I was gonna try to salvage the projectors out of them. I got power steering lines, which to be honest, I actually don't need to replace. I bought them because I thought I needed to replace them, but they weren't leaking. It's my oil cooler lines. crack windshield. I think I cracked my windshield when I did my stuff. Let's put my cab lights in, but the switch is to the light bar in the front. That is a mirror from a 2000 and I think it was a 2001 Chevy truck. It's got the dual display with the compass and the temperature. The original one I just had compass. It still got the auto dimming, which is pretty cool. I kind of wish they offered the tow mirrors with auto dimming. That really comes in useful. I can't really think of anything else. I would show the lights, but phone's almost dead. I got it plugged in right now. And plus I got another video for all my lights if somebody wants to do it. I got the Auxbeam F16s in today. I'm fixing to pull it in the garage and install those. While I'm at it, I might install that grill. But I'm thinking, no, I want to show under the hood. Oops, that was my brakes. Let me pause real quick. I'm going to go get my battery backup. Actually, let's see. Oh, let's just do it real quick. 350 Vortec. The whole AC system besides this main line that loops around is new. Condenser's new. Compressor's new. Evaporator's new. And everything else. Radiator's new. I got it. Radiator's cracked. I did the Vortec box delete. I got a Spectra filter in here. Why did I not close that all the way the other day? I obviously have HIDs, but those are fixing to go out. I guess I'm one of the few that actually have the truck box in it. Keep power steering fluid in there because power steering fluid does leak. I think it's coming out of the power steering box and the pump. I think that's... Oops. Yeah, phone died, so, that was pretty much it anyway. I got everything I wanted to, pretty much. And I might be forgetting something, but, yeah. Anyway, that's pretty much it. I'm fixing to install those Auxbeam headlights, so I'll probably do another video on that. Keep my phone here charging while I take some stuff apart. Because it died. Luckily, the video saved. Talk to y'all later. Bye.